Amen. What a joy it is to have you with us in the house of the Lord this morning. If you love Jesus, say amen. Amen. If you don't love Jesus, we hope before you leave, you will fall in love with him. Amen. Amen. For those that don't know who I am Pastor Thomas Odom. I have the privilege of serving here at this local church as the lead pastor. And we are delighted to have the PYFC organization with us today. If you love PYFC, can I hear you just say amen? Amen. What a joy it is to have the leadership and so many churches from so many different parts in this state with us. And we want you just to get right in. It's a little bit of housekeeping this morning. We're going to have church until church is over. Everything else will wait. So I'm going to just ask youth groups and youth pastors, even when we get to the altar time, if you'll just ensure your youth group stays close to the sanctuary until we're all done. And then everything else will follow after that. We'll give instructions about where to change clothes and campus layout, things of that later. Bathrooms are right in the double doors there, so you should not have to go far. I'm going to ask Brother Tony to come. He's the leader of our PYFC organization. Would you welcome him to this pulpit as he comes this morning? Brother Tony.
Thank you, buddy. Thank you. Isn't it good to be in the house of the Lord on a Saturday morning? You know, the Lord has a plan for this service today. He had you in mind. He knew who was going to be here, and he knows what you have need of. Before you even got here, he has the key to what you need. If we'll create that atmosphere for him to come down, he'll respond to worship. He'll respond to that true heart worship that says, God, I got to have you. I need you, Lord. I need you to guide me. If you would, let's stand across the building this morning. Let's lift our hands and let's invite the Holy Ghost into this house today, God. Dear Heavenly Father, God, as we come to you, Lord, God, we're in desperate need, God, of your spirit, God. God, we're in desperate need, God, of an encounter with you today, God. I ask you, Holy Ghost, God, to saturate this service, to move in, God. We ask you, Lord God, to come in and set up house, God. God, we ask you, Lord, to anoint the singing, God, anoint the preaching, the man of God that's coming around, God. I ask you, Lord God, to minister, God, to every need here, God. The needs are many, Father, but God, you are the one answer, God. We look to you, Father, today, God, in the name of Jesus. God, we love you and we praise you. Sister Tish is coming around with Sister Natalie. They're going to open us up, start us open up a song. You can continue standing if you like. How many's ready to worship? If we'll worship him today, God will respond. There's no telling what'll happen in this house today. I'm telling you, Saturday morning, God can visit Ocoee Church of God and meet you right where you are if you'll open up his heart to him.
I was just around my house last night and just doing some stuff and thinking about the service today. And I generally do this when we're getting ready to have one of these PYFC services. I just begin to talk to the Lord and, you know, what is it that our young people need to hear? What do we need to be telling them? What do we need to be communicating to them? And as I was doing that last night, some of you will think this is silly, and that's all right, but that little song that we all learned as kids just came back to me and would not leave me last night and has not left me this morning, and I'm going to sing that little kid song that says, Jesus loves me, this I know. You know, as I was praying last night, he began to just kind of take me back, and I got in here this morning, and I went to the book of Jeremiah, where the Lord spoke. I recorded this for us, and he said, yea, I have loved thee with an everlasting love, never ending, never dying. And I began to think about me. And I'm not always easy to love. I know me well enough to know that. I have more faults than I have good points. I know me well enough to know that. But oh, the thought that Jesus loves me. And he does this morning. The unlovable on my bad days, on my tough days, he still loves me. When I'm fighting the worst fight of my life, and nobody else knows, and seems like nobody else cares, Jesus still loves me. I don't understand that this morning, I'll be honest with you, that the creator of all of the universe knows my name and loves me. But he does this morning. Everybody knows this little song, and so everybody can help me sing it this morning. Jesus. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. For the Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me, this I know. For the Bible tells me so. Little ones to Him belong. They are weak, but yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. For the Bible tells me so. And yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. For the Bible tells me so.
Aren't you glad of that this morning? He does love us. Sister Natalie's going to sing for y'all.
I will bless the Lord forever.
At PYFC services, we just do things right on the fly. We don't practice, we just do it on the fly. Feet upon a rock, and I will not be moved, and I'll say of the Lord, You are my shield, my strength, my portion.
shelter, strong tower, my very present help. You are my shield, my strength, my portion. Deliver my shelter, strong tower, my very present help in time of need. Whom have I in heaven but you? There is none I desire besides you. And you have made me glad. Now say of the Lord, you are my shield, my strength, my portion. Deliver my shelter, strong tower, my very present help. You are my shield, my strength, my portion. Deliver my shelter, strong tower, my very present help in time of need. I will bless the Lord forever. I will trust Him at all times, for He has delivered me from all fear. He has set my feet upon a rock, and I will not be moved. And I'll say of the Lord, you are my strength, my strength, my portion. Deliver my shelter, strong tower, my very present help. You are my shield, my strength, my portion. Deliver my shelter, strong tower, my very present help in time of need.
Yes, amen. We're getting ready to bring the choir around, but just right quick, I do have one quick announcement. Brother Aaron, raise your hand, buddy. Brother Aaron has his stuff here for background checks if you want to work camp next year. He has brought his stuff to get set up. The laws changed this year. I believe it was July the 1st, if I'm not mistaken. If you had it done 2 or 3 years ago, we have to run you through again. So I would like to get the poolers while they're here, and then the PYFC staff as well is going to be doing that. So Brother Aaron will be set up, and if you don't mind, if you're going to work camp, I'll need you to see him, if you don't mind. So, but at this time, I want the choir to come around, and this is going to include even future campers, below the 11 years old. So won't y'all come on up? Sister Rachel's going to come around, or she's going to help lead us off. That's right. Give them a hand. Come on, choir. I want y'all to sing. This is a good-looking bunch this morning, ain't it? Thank you.
say amen.
We're all on a journey, and we're called to walk by faith. There'll always be the mountains and valleys in our way. But right here in this moment, may our strength be renewed as we recall what God has done and how we've seen Him move. If there's anybody here who's found Him faithful, anybody here who knows He's able, say amen. If there's anybody here who's seen His power, anybody here run through the fire, say amen. Anybody here found joy in the midst of sorrow, peace in the storm, hope for tomorrow? We've seen it time and time again. Just say amen. It gets hard to see. Oh, but be bold and courageous and follow where He leads. Greater is the One who's in us than he who's in the world. So child of God, remember the battle is the Lord's. If there's anybody here who's found Him faithful, anybody here
through the fire, say,
only had planned for one, but I guess we'll do another one. Which one do y'all want to do? Ocean Deep, Chain Breaker. Got Chain Breaker. All right.
That he is. Yes, amen.
Amen. He is a chain breaker. Thank you, Jesus. Let's start with a chorus, y'all. You ready?
If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, he's a risen, shaken savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker.
If you've been walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice tell the same old lies, if you're trying to fill them same old holes inside, there's a better life. There's a better life. If you've got pain,
he's a pain taker.
You feel lost,
you feel lost, he's a way.
For the light of day and the dead of night, we've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. We've all run to things we know just ain't right. Oh, but there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain,
he's a pain taker.
Thank you, choir. Thank you. Didn't they sing, church? Yes, amen. While they're going down, I just want to take a moment to thank Brother Odom and the Ocoee Church for opening up their house to us to let us come to have this service. We appreciate you, buddy. We appreciate your church for sponsoring this camp, backing us, bringing your youth. You come to our meetings up north. You come. Well, they broke down the last one we had, and so sorry that Rebecca got left out there and she had to turn around and come back, but they made the effort to come. Brother Odom, we really appreciate you and your church for backing this ministry here. He's a good God this morning, ain't he?
Amen.
I'm telling you, I believe he wants to do something in this house today for somebody. We're not gathered together just to have a social meeting. We're here to worship the King of the Kings and the Lord of Lords. He wants to move in your soul today.
Yes.
I ask you to open it up. Open up your heart. Sister Caraway's coming around. She's going to sing, her and her girl. So let's worship the Lord.
Lord, lay this song in my heart this morning to sing. We're going to sing a different one. But like he said, this isn't just a time of worship. This is a place where we come to gather in his name. This song says, take me to the place. Y'all be my choir out there and y'all help us sing. I know most of y'all know it.
Take me to the place where your peace and your love overflows, where my heart is set free from all shame and guilt and chains are undone. Take me there. Take me there. Take me to the place where your peace and your love overflows, where my heart is set free from all shame and guilt, chains are undone. Take me there, take me there, 'cause I wanna know what it feels like when heaven touches earth and I'm caught in between. And I wanna know what it feels like for the glory of the Lord to fall on me. Take me there, take me there. So take me to the place where your angels never cease to cry, holy, where the elders bow down and cast all of their crowns at your feet. Take me there, take me there, 'cause I wanna know what it feels like when heaven touches earth and I'm caught in between. And I wanna know what it feels like for the glory of the Lord to fall on me. Take me there, take me there. And you come like a rushing wind. I can't speak or stand, just cry holy. And you flow like a mighty rain, overtaking me with your glory. And you come like a rushing wind. I can't speak or stand, just cry holy. And you flow like a mighty rain, overtaking me with your glory. Heaven touches earth and I'm caught in between. And I want to know what it feels like, the glory of the Lord to fall on me. Take me there, take me there.
There we go. There we go. Yes, amen. Lord, we love you, Jesus. God, I do thank you. Well, at this time, Brother Pooler is getting ready to come around. If he looks a little stressed or a little, maybe his hair's falling out or he's giving away his daughter next weekend, and he might be having a slight problem with that. So if he gets a little angry in his message, you just might have to kind of overlook that and understand where he's coming from. But we do appreciate Brother Pooler and what he's done to work for the camp. He's got out there and helped with you kids. He sang in our altar services to help the spirit to flow and to move. We appreciate him and his family. I don't know he can do what, if he wants to sing, if Renee wants to sing, she's more than welcome to come on up. We're not in no hurry. We're here to just worship the Lord and let him have his way today. Amen.
Praise God. Amen. It's so good to be in the house of the Lord. Can you say amen? Amen. Amen. I feel the Holy Ghost in this place. Hallelujah. He's here to touch us and to bless us. Amen. I count it a privilege to be able to come preach to you. Amen. I appreciate Brother Tony and the staff for asking us to come and be with you today. Amen. I have a burden for you young people. I love to go to camp. We're involved in three camps, and we've only been involved with PYFC for about 2 or 3 years now. And amen, I'm excited every time it comes around, because I love to see you young people getting in and worshiping God. Man, oh man, we've seen so many filled with the Holy Ghost this year and this past summer, and the glory of God came down, and each and every night, different ones, amen, were seeking way past while we're out, amen, eating pizza, amen. But ones are getting filled with the power of the Holy Ghost, and it's that kind of hunger, amen, that just keeps the river flowing, amen. Are you glad you're here today? Amen. Well, I am a bit stressed, amen, but I am blessed on top of it. Praise God. You heard that saying, too blessed to be stressed. I need one more blessing, Lord. Just pour it out on me, amen, so that I can feel the blessing greater than the stress. Praise the Lord. But I never could imagine, amen, how stressful it would be. Amen. But it's all going to be over after a while. Glory to God. Amen. Do you love Jesus today? Appreciate each and every one of you. Appreciate Brother Odom and his staff and his church for opening this up to us, amen, to have church and to raise funds, amen, for this youth camp. It's so important that we can get just as many there as we can, amen, because your souls are important, your lives are important, the decisions that you make, amen, the always come from Christ, amen. That's where our decisions need to be based on. Jesus Christ. And we got him in our lives. He's going to lead us and he's going to guide us. Sometimes it's not exactly what we're looking for, but I can guarantee you, amen, it's the best when Jesus decides for you. If you have your Bibles with you today, turn with me to the book of St. John, chapter number 4. I want to begin reading in verse number 7, a very familiar passage of Scripture to us, amen, about that woman at Samaria. I'm glad, amen, Jesus just goes out of his way just for us. Amen. Sometimes we don't feel like we're very important, but I believe Jesus believes we're important. Important to the kingdom of God. And you young people are important. Amen. You'll bear with me. Amen. This one didn't make it to the computer yet. Amen. So I'm preaching the old time way. I got these little tabs in my Bible, and hopefully they'll stick when I pull on them. Amen. Stand with me for the reading of his word. Amen. St. John chapter number 4. I'll begin reading in verse number 7. We'll read on down through verse number 15. There cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus saith unto her, give me to drink. For his disciples were gone away into the city to buy meat. Then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, how is it that thou, being a Jew, askest drink of me, which am a woman of Samaria? For the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans. Jesus answered and said unto her, if thou knewest the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, give me to drink, thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. The woman saith unto him, sir, thou hast nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. From whence then hast thou that living water? Art thou the greater than the father Jacob, which gave us the well and drank thereof himself and his children and his cattle? Jesus answered and said unto her, Whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again, but whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst, but the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray together. Ask God to anoint us here today. Heavenly Father, we love you. We thank you, Lord, for the privilege that we have to gather together in your name. I ask you, dear Lord God, that you would touch each and every heart, that these young people's hearts would be opened unto you. And oh, dear God, would you let that well flow in this place? Dear God, let us, each and every one, take a drink of that living water here today, that you would stir us, that you would awaken us, that you would help us here today to receive more of you. I pray for an outpouring of the Holy Ghost in our altar service here today, that your divine will would be done and hearts would be blessed, and we'll give you all the glory in Jesus' name and amen. You might be seated. Amen. Jesus spoke to her and said, give me to drink. Amen. I want to preach that this morning. Amen. Give me to drink. Praise the Lord. There's something about the water that Jesus is all about. He wants to pour himself into us. Amen. He wants us to be so full of his power and his glory that we might be able to do his will. Now, Jesus has an answer for every individual in this place. Amen. You might feel like that you go through things that nobody else goes through, but Jesus knows exactly what you're going through, and he's willing to go completely out of his way to come to you to give you exactly what you need today. Praise the Lord. Amen. Jesus has gone out of his way, amen, to go to Samaria and over here to the Samaritan woman. Amen. He knew she was going to be there. Amen. He spoke to her. Amen. And he already knew what she needed in her life. Amen. He already knew the secrets of her past, and he knew her present situation. Don't ever think that Jesus don't know what you're going through. You might feel lonely at times. I can just tell you, Jesus is right there with you. He's gone completely out of his way, amen, to wrap his arms around you, to lift you up, amen, and to help you along the way. It's not a time to get discouraged. It's not a time to allow the enemy, amen, to bombard you and say you cannot make it, because you can. The Bible says that I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me, and Christ is right there with you to help you right on time. Hallelujah. Amen. Now, Jesus was not asking her for water. Amen. We know that he was probably thirsty. He's gone a long way. But that's not the exact reason why he's there. Sometimes, amen, Jesus will get our attention, amen, and draw us in because he wants to help us. Amen. How many's ever heard of a conversation piece? Amen. The well's just a conversation piece. The drink of water is just a conversation piece. Amen. But what Jesus is about to do is forgive her of her sins. Amen. To transform her life. She's no longer going to be a woman of ill repute. Amen. But she's going to be a saint of God. And she's going to carry what God pours into her unto those that lives all around her. That's what I like. When Jesus pours into us, now wherever we go, amen, it's going to get on somebody else. You ever seen those folks that testify and they get real excited? Anybody ever seen one of them? I know they're few and far between anymore. There's a whole lot of them gets up, testify, you know, I thank God I'm saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost, and y'all pray. Woo! Amen. It's hard to shout when you hear a testimony like that. Amen. But when you see somebody testify, man, they start feeling it. Amen. They can't just stand in their pew anymore. They got to step out in the aisle. Amen. Because they start remembering what God done for them. That's that water being poured into them. And now it's flowing out. Praise God. Every Christian that's ever drank of this water, amen, ought to experience that continual flow of the Spirit in their life. Amen. We ought to be excited this morning that we're saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost. Praise the Lord. Allow the Lord, amen, to flow through you. Amen. Jesus was not asking when he said, give me a drink. Amen. But Jesus was offering answers unto her when he said, give me to drink. Give me to drink. Let me pour in myself to you so that you can go out and give me to drink to somebody else. Now, there's something about the water, Jesus, that will give you an awakening. Amen. How many still sleepy this morning? Amen. I'm starting to feel a little bit better. Amen. It took a while, and I was still, when I got here, it felt like, you know, amen, somebody was pulling on the backs of my eyeballs. Amen. I'm going, oh, help me to wake up. Help me to wake up. Help me to wake up. Amen. There's many times when we come to church and we feel like that. But it is an amazing, amen, how the power of God can awaken us. How many love to be woke up? Don't we have any participators here? Amen. Nobody really loves to be woke up. Amen. I know when we're at youth camp, you stay up all night. Now, God's called me to do something else. Amen. Now, some of you are called to be counselors and can stay up all night long, but I thank God he ain't called me to do that. Amen. But then when you stay up all night long and you're, amen, and they want to wake you up at 7 o'clock in the morning. Amen, it's hard. I can see some of you when you come to breakfast, one eye's open and you forgot to comb your hair. Amen, but we don't really like to be awakened, but there's, amen, power in this Word of God that will awaken us. Amen, no yawning. Amen. It's a type of awakening, that water that when it hits you, amen, it does something for you. And you will react to it. Amen. It's that Word of God. It's the Lord Jesus Christ. And he comes by. Amen. And he knows you need a touch. He might see you starting to slough off a little bit. Now, spiritually, amen, there's a lot of people that are falling into that category of the great falling away. You heard about that in Sunday school? That great falling away, that in the last days, amen, there'll be a whole lot that are falling away from Christ than coming to Christ. And we're living in that day. Amen. Amen. But it is the grace of God that he comes by and right on time he awakens us. And we feel, amen. I'm not sure if that scripture says that he's in the midst or he's in the mist. Amen. Oh, I'm pretty sure what it says. Amen. Amen. But when Jesus comes by, he wants to awaken us, and he wants to stir us up. Amen. Have you ever heard a message that sort of steps on your toes? The preacher don't know what you're going through. Amen. But you're sure that somebody told him. Once he started preaching and reading your mail, amen, and telling you exactly, amen, what you're going through, amen, and he comes by and he awakens you. Amen, that Word of God gets a hold of you and it gets you right in the face. Amen, and all of a sudden you're awake and you see, amen, that's exactly where I'm at. Amen, now some reacted with a smile and some reacted like this. And that reaction, amen, to the Word of God says it all. Amen. It says what we're going to go through tomorrow.
Jesus knows we need the answers for our present situation. We've gone through so much in the past. He's got an answer for that. And whatever valley we're walking through right now, amen, sometimes it ain't easy. When Jesus comes by and awakens us with that word of God, sometimes we're going, oh yes, man, that feels good. And some of us are going, oh, I'm not sure. Amen. But you know when you're feeling something, God's talking to you. It's not just another sermon, amen, but it's a true answer. There's something about the water that's going to bring me out of this. Jesus has gone out of his way just for me. Praise God, I don't have to perish. I don't have to fall by the wayside. Amen, Jesus come by to lift me up right on time. And we need that awakening and that stirring in our hearts, amen, to bring us to the place where we can make the right decision in our lives. Amen. Hallelujah. There's something about the water that brings a refreshing. Amen. Now, how many of you young people work hard? Some of you still feel young. Amen. And you work hard. Amen. It was nice and cool this morning, wasn't it? Can we just have this from right on here until next summer? No, there's going to be some hot days. Welcome to Florida. Amen. But we get out in that heat and it's so hot. Amen. And we're working hard, and it's the same way spiritually. For you young people, amen, it isn't easy just staying on fire for God. Amen, you got to have a pastor that's going to pump you and prime you and encourage you and lift you up. Amen, because, amen, you're out there working hard. And you're fighting the devil. Amen, public school's so full of the devil. Some of you are blessed. You don't have to go to public school. I wished I would have had that privilege and option when I was a young person, so it was so difficult to stay on fire for God. But you're working hard, and you're working hard. And when you get that blessing, isn't it a refreshing? When God refills you and touches you, we get that refreshing when we go to youth camp. Amen. My voice was almost gone when I left there. Amen. I mean, it was about gone, and I was squeaking in the next revival when I had to go preach. Amen. But what a refreshing when my voice came back to me. What a refreshing and a fresh anointing that I felt when you get to youth camp. It's different, isn't it? It's different. I mean, you know, we won't have church at our home church just like we do at youth camp. But when we get to youth camp, there's something special. There must be a well, amen, in that place. And that's what we look forward to, is that refreshing, amen, to get that drink of water that we need. Amen. Praise God. There's nothing more refreshing. How many wants to drink after me? Just one. Man, just making sure you're awake. Amen. Anybody thirsty in this place? Yeah, take a drink of that water. Amen. That's yours to keep. Everybody hesitates. I'm holding the water out. It's an invitation for a refreshing. It's the word of God. It's exactly what we need. Sometimes we don't even know what we need. We just know we need a touch from heaven. Amen. And Jesus is always there. Amen. And he's reaching out, saying, here you go. Come unto me, ye that are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Praise the Lord. And he's holding out. But it's amazing how everybody hesitates. Well, and sometimes we wait for How many has a sister faithful in your church? Amen. We're waiting for Sister Faithful to step out. Soon as Sister Faithful steps out and goes, "Woo!" we all know to start praising God. Amen. And that's a lot of it. Sometimes we're waiting, amen, for that certain one. I want to be Brother Faithful, don't you? Amen. I want you to be Brother and Sister Faithful in your church. Amen. The water's there. The well's overflowing. And when the invitation is given, let's not stand back and hesitate. Amen, but let's step out, praise God. Amen, now you're going to enjoy that water for the rest of the service. Just a little sip at a time. Now there's some, amen, that they're really thirsty. They're just going to chug that thing. I mean, they're going to empty it out. Amen, and they feel that refreshing for a moment. Amen, there's a lot of people that come to church and they get all excited. Amen, and they feel that refreshing, and they take that big old chug. Amen, and all of a sudden, 5 minutes later, they're going, "Oh, that was too much water. Can we get too much at one time?" A lot of people get over-encouraged, don't they? Amen. I remember when God first called me to preach, and it took me 7 years to say yes. You know, I was scared to death to preach the gospel. But then when I finally said, "Yes, Lord, I'll preach the gospel," amen, it was 3.5 years later before I could go full time. Amen. And I thought, God, it took me 7 years to say yes. Can't we just go on? Deliver me from this job, amen, getting up at 5 o'clock in the morning, driving through this Orlando traffic, amen, for the next 3.5 years, and preach the gospel once in a while. God, please deliver me. But God's saying, just take one sip at a time. Just one sip at a time, amen. Learn of me. Grow strong in the Lord. Let's not get too much at once, young people. Amen. But as you grow, start out young. Get hungry. Get thirsty. Come every time you come, get in the altar and get another sip of that water. Amen. Just one more cup. There's something about that water that's going to make you a true soldier of the Lord Jesus Christ. God's going to train you up and give you strength and power. Hallelujah. Amen. We need that refreshing from the Lord. Acts 3:19 says, "Repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, when the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord." Amen. Nothing wrong with repenting. Repenting's just saying, "I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Lord." Amen. There's many times when even us saved folks need to say, "I'm sorry." But every time we do, amen, we get another sip of that water. Another touch from heaven. Another touch that fills us up and helps us and lifts us up right on time. Hallelujah. Amen. There is nothing more refreshing than a constant flow of the presence of the Lord. The more you respond to the Lord when He invites you, keeps that constant flow in your life. If you'll ever notice, amen, when you're getting in and praising God, and maybe you got in at youth camp and you're, amen, just praising the Lord, tears are flowing in every service, 2 services a day, you're feeling that refreshing, you're feeling that touch, but then when you get back home, you fall right back into the same rut that you were in before, amen, and you don't come to every service. Well, Mom and Dad wouldn't bring me. Make them feel guilty if you have to. Amen. Tell them how much you love Jesus. Tell them I need to get to the house of God. Make whatever arrangements, amen, that you have to. I mean, you do when they tell you you're going to the amusement park, and then something comes up and they say, "Well, we can't do that." Boy, you throw a fit. Amen. You want to know why? And you want to know why today? Amen. We need to change our schedules, Mom and Dad, because I've been looking forward to this. Well, when we hear the word of God, and God, amen, entices us, he holds out that water. Praise the Lord, son, never hesitate, but step out and let God touch you. And each and every time you do, amen, that constant flow is going to flow in your life. Amen. You're not going to have as many struggles in this life when you stay that close to the well and God keeps pouring into you himself. Amen. And then when you go out into the highways and into the hedges, amen, you have the right words to say. You go on that mission field, amen, and you wonder, why me, Lord? I'm so shy. Amen. But the words start flowing and the power and the anointing touches lives all over this world. Hallelujah. It is so important, amen, that you get in, stay close, and stay refreshed. Amen. There's something about the water that will be remembered for an eternity. Never take for granted coming to church, young people. Never take for granted the privilege that you have to go to PYFC Youth Camp. To get in and allow God to touch your lives, never take for granted for that, because that refreshing will always be remembered. Amen. Over in the book of Luke, chapter number 16, we read in verse 23 and 24. And in hell, how many believes there's a hell? Raise your hand. It's real. Amen. We know the word of God is real. And these red letters that I'm reading to you, Jesus said, and in hell he lift up his eyes being in torments and seeth Abraham afar off and Lazarus in his bosom. And he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me and send Lazarus that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am tormented in this flame. He remembers the water. Young people, we're going to remember if we are to go to that dreaded place. We'll remember every sermon that we ever heard. We'll remember, amen, that touch of conviction. Every invitation that we had to go to the altar. Some young people think they're tormented because they have to come to church. But count it a privilege that you're in church. Count it a privilege. Amen. I always hated to be a preacher's kid. Amen. Because we're going whether we like it or not. But you preacher's kids, count it a privilege. Amen, that you're able to go and are escaping all the corruption of this lost and dying world. Amen, that wants to take you under and destroy your life. Amen, think about that drink of water. Think about that warm meal. Think about that nice place you've got to sleep. Think about the blessings that are in your life. Because there came a day in my life when I had rejected the water. I had rejected the word. Amen. And wished that I could be back home. Amen. In that comfortable bed, scooting up to the table to have something decent to eat. The devil don't care about you. He don't care about what he does. He just wants to destroy your lives. But Jesus, he's watching you every step of the way. And if you get way out in Samaria, amen, in a rejected place, Jesus is going to come by just in time and say, I've come by to say I love you one more time. One more time. Amen. And it'll be in the dark hour when you take a drink of that water. Don't ever get to that place. I've told some, this is why I have such a heavy burden for you young people. Amen. And I can't help when you're praying in the altar to just walk around. And I try to pray for each and every one, as many as I can. And I'm weeping and I'm crying. Amen. Because I knew that when I was your age, I had gotten out, so far out. Amen. Maybe I shouldn't even tell this, but I told Tony, I think. Amen. That when I went to a Church of God youth camp, I was so far out into sin that I'm sneaking off the grounds into the woods and I'm smoking dope at youth camp. And I see my life and where it was and where it led me. And I see you young people and you're so exposed to so much more than I was that many years ago. And I weep and I cry. But I see Jesus coming by. And he spoke to me one day, Brother Tony, and he said, "Give me to drink." Amen. And so he comes and he fills me up. And he gives me everything I need. Everything I desire. And he washes away all of my sins and my corruption. Amen. And he gives me one more chance. Hallelujah. And he comes by, Brother Shane, and he tells me, "I want you to preach this gospel to them and tell them, give me to drink. So I got to give you a portion of what God's given me. And that's yours. You drink it up. You take it with you wherever you go. And the more you drink, it'll be amazing, but God will fill it right back up. He'll fill it right back up to where you're able to go. And so you're going to run across somebody that's going to need it, and you could hand it to them. Stand with me today. Jesus has come by this place. I know we're going to have fun today. But before we have fun, we're going to drink from the well, Brother Josh. God's going to touch each and every life. Some of you, I'm sure, has had struggles since August to today. And Jesus come by Ocoee. Some of you have traveled miles to get here. Amen. And Jesus is already here. Boy, I can feel his presence. Amen. And he's now wanting to pour out himself into us. Fill us up. Touch our hearts just in time. Amen. And you know what you need and desire in your heart. Jesus already has the answer here today. What I have for you is special today. What I have brought for you to consume will cleanse, will heal, will encourage. And I have come here today to touch your souls. You've been dedicated to me, therefore ye are mine, saith the Lord. And I will take care of mine own. Come unto me and believe and trust. I will give you of myself that ye may thirst no more, saith the Lord. Holy God. How many knows you belong to God today? I want us to gather in. I mean, there's some here that really need a drink. And I know you're going to hesitate for a moment. But
But I know you want that drink. Don't be embarrassed. But step out right now. Say, Brother Pooler, I really need a drink of Jesus today. I ain't told a lot of folks what I'm going through, but you don't really have to. Jesus already knows. Would you step out and come to this altar? Say, yeah, Brother Pooler, I want a drink of that water. I want a refreshing in my life. I want you to touch me today. And he's come by this way to give you exactly what you need today. Come on, let's obey the Lord. Hallelujah. There's some of you that are so full and on fire. He's telling you, give me to drink. Amen. So come and let's gather around these young people. Let's give of ourselves to them what Jesus has given unto us. In the name of the Lord, touch us here today in Jesus' name.
But you keep on working.
Touch us here today in Jesus'
name. When you're running on empty,
pour out your glory
and you
in your
spirit. Find the remedy. Just come to the well, and all who thirst will thirst no more, and all who search will find what their souls long for. The world will try, but it can never feel, so leave it all behind. Come to the well. You can spend your whole life chasing what's missing, the empty inside. It just ain't gonna listen when nothing can satisfy, and the world leaves you high and dry. Just come to the well, and all who thirst will thirst no more, and all who search will find what their souls long for. The world will try, and it will never feel, so leave it all behind. And come to the well, and all who thirst will thirst no more, and all who search will find what their souls long for. The world will try, but it can never feel, leave it all behind. Come to the well. So bring me your heart, no matter how broken. Just come as you are. When your last prayer is spoken, just rest in my arms a while. You'll feel the change, my child, when you come to the well. And all who thirst will thirst no more, and all who search will find what their souls long for. The world will try, but it can never feel, so leave it all behind and come to the well. And all who thirst will thirst no more, and all who search will find what their souls long for. The world will try, but it can never fail. behind. Come to the well. I have what you need, but you keep on searching. I've done all the work, but you keep on working. When you're running on empty and you can't find the remedy, just come to the well, and all you thirst, well, thirst no more. No, who search, will find what their souls long for. The world will try, but it can never feel. Leave it all behind. Come to the well. You can spend your whole life chasing what's missing, but that empty inside, it just ain't gonna listen. When nothing can satisfy and the world leaves you high and dry, just come to the well, and all who thirst will thirst no more. And all who search will find what their souls long for. The world will try, it can never feel. Leave it all behind. Come to the well. So bring me your heart, no matter how broken. Just come as you are. When your last prayer is spoken, just rest in my arms a while. You'll feel the change, my child, when you come to the well. In a well, thirst, well, thirst no more. And all who search will find what their souls long for. The world will try, but it can never feel. So leave it all behind. Come to the well. And now that you're full of love beyond measure, your joy's gonna flow like a stream in the desert. Soon all the world will see that living water is found in me, 'cause you came to the well. And all who thirst will thirst no more. And all who search will find what their souls long for. The world will try, but it can never feel. So leave it all behind. Come to the well. So bring me your heart, no matter how broken. Just come as you are. When your last prayer is spoken, just rest in my arms a while. You feel the change, my child, when you come to the well. And oh, who thirst, well, thirst no more. And all who search will find what their souls long for. The world will try, but it will never feel. So leave it all behind. Come to the well. If you provide the fire, I'll provide the sacrifice. if you pour out your spirit, then I will open up inside. So fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. And fill me up till I overflow. I want to run over. I want to run over. Fill me up till I overflow. I want to run over. I want to run over. Fill me up till I overflow. I want to run over. I want to run over. So fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. So fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up in love of God. Overflow, permeate all my soul. Love of God, overflow, permeate all my soul. So fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. And fill me up till I overflow. I want to run over. I want to run over. Fill me up till I overflow. I want to run over. I want to run over. So fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up.
the sacrifice. You pour out your spirit. I will open up inside. So fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. So fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. So fill me up till I overflow. I wanna run over. I wanna run over. Fill me up till I overflow. I wanna run over. I wanna run over. Fill me up. Thank you.
Amen. How many is thankful that he has the water for your soul tonight? He has everything that you need. Thank you for that message, Brother Pooler. We appreciate you. But I'm telling you what, me and Lynn would have gave you $20 if you would have sprayed Tish right there while you was right there at it. We was hooked. Everybody was looking around when he had that spray bottle. You was at your attention then for sure. We thank you, Ocoee Church, other churches, Clewiston's here, Samoset's here. I hate to start calling. We got some McClenny folks here from wherever you came from today. I'm so delighted that you came. You chose to spend your Saturday morning with us. You could have been on the lake fishing. You could have been scouting in the woods for that big deer for hunting season coming up. But you decided to come spend it with us, and I want to say thank you. I appreciate that very much for these young people. Young people, I don't know every one of you by name. I don't know your name, but I want you to know I love you. We're pulling for you. That's why we have these meetings. That's why we have these camps, because that pull of the world out there is strong. There's a whole lot that it has to offer you now. And unless their church becomes to be the church to push back the forces of hell, we're going to lose you. And I don't want to lose one of them. I don't want to lose. Every last one of you are precious. Every last one of you. You're a gift from the Lord. I don't know where you come from, what your background holds, but I'm telling you, with Jesus, I can tell you what your future will be. He wants to use you. He needs young people, and especially in these schools, to stand up and say, Christ is the way. Because there's a whole lot of answer. There's a whole lot of junk out there, but the truth needs to be told. But once again, I do appreciate you very much, Brother Josh. I appreciate all of y'all for helping us in this ministry. I want to say it's good to have Sister Sandra with us today. 25 years ago, her and her husband started this ministry out of a tragedy in their own personal life. In 25 years, it's still going on, reaching out, touching young people. It's good to have her with us here today. Her and her husband were very instrumental in my life, helping to shape and mold me then the Lord's still working on me. But it's good to have her. One thing Sister Tish wanted me to mention about the background check. If you was at Camp Keystone the first year and you had it done there the first year, you need to do it again, correct? Because of the laws that have just recently changed. And Brother Aaron is here and will have his stuff set up. And I believe that's all I got. Brother Odom's getting ready to come around. He's going to close us out and give you some instructions of what you need to do. And keep your eye, one more thing, keep your eye on the website concerning camp next year. There may be some slight changes coming. It looks like we're still going to have the same date. I'm waiting to hear from Brother Sam. They should be meeting in November, having their board meeting to set their schedule. It looks like it is going to be that same week, but I really don't want to say anything because I don't know yet, but it possibly may be a Tuesday to Saturday camp. I want to go ahead and just get that out. But keep your eye on the website. As soon as we have some information, we'll update that so you can make preparations for that. And that's all I have. You got anything, Sister Tish? Anything else? Their first year. So, all right, if you would put your hands together, just give this Lord Jesus of ours a hand clap. Brother Thomas is coming around.
If you love PYFC, give the Lord a hand clap for PYFC this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Let me take just a moment and give some instructions that may help you if you're visiting with us today, and also for our home folks. When it comes to our dismissal here, we're going to let you go ahead and change and go and partake of the activities. Lunch is not ready quite yet. Obviously, they want to be in church with you, so it'll take a little while longer, according to the PYFC leadership. So we will let you know when lunch is ready. We'll make sure you don't get left out.